Hello, I'm here with Matt Mitchell, who is of Tactical Tech and various other organizations.
Yeah.
Welcome.
Thank you. It's great to be here, Bruce.
So tell me what you do.
Well, I like to call myself a hacker, but one that's focused on public interest technology. I'm able to have a full career only working with nonprofits, civil society, and really just giving back. And I love explaining to people that it's a viable space for all of us, all technologists.
So when you, for Tactical Tech, what is your, what's your role?
My official title at Tactical Tech is Director of Digital Safety and Privacy. And what I do there is I assist the organization, of course, with their organizational security, but also with making sure that the amazing materials that they put out for regular folks, our common humans on this planet, to learn about digital privacy, politics, and a little bit of advocacy, that it's all safe and all the latest information's in there.
So you're mixing tech and public relations and activism and a little bit of journalism, trying to make it all work.
Trying to make it all work, and so far people have really had an appetite for it. When they started with these data detox kits, as they call them, just a lot of people feel like, you know what, I want to maybe curtail my information flow to a lot of these tech firms, or you know, I don't know how to go about doing that, and it gives people a path to do that, and I think it's really exciting, and people really have responded really positively to those data detox kits. But also we have research, people who are really want to get in there, pages and pages, screens and screens of research, people who want to get into that, and it's really exciting to have content, not preaching to the choir, reaching people wherever they are and giving them an inroad to high quality, well-researched info that's digitally safe.
And this is around the world. Tactical Tech is based in Berlin. You're based in New York.
That's correct.
Are you traveling? Is it US only? Are you doing everything?
I do it all. Of course, I love New York City. I'm based in New York. Tactical Tech has a team that's international. Even though we are in Berlin, there's only a few Germans on staff. And we have quite a few people from all around the world, whether they're in Romania, whether they're in the MENA region, whether they, English is not their first language. And it helps us speak to the rest of the world to have that large collection of people, a really multicultural, it's a really great gender balance, a lot of powerful women in the organization. We do a lot of work that's talking about the women's rights online and protecting women online. That's a very highly targeted group, and I love being there with Tactical Tech because the internet doesn't have borders, so why should our organizations that talk about privacy?
Okay, so before we started, you told me Tactical Tech is about half of what you do.
Yeah.
And I know you, many years ago, you were running PGP key signing parties in Harlem.
That's right.
So what else is what else makes up your work?
I do a lot of work in the inner city inside the United States, whether that's Los Angeles, Oakland, New York City, Miami, and in there I talk to people who are usually find themselves on the targeted end of surveillance. And we all know that surveillance has some like negative parts, right? It can be really dangerous to a democracy and to a people, but it's not metered out evenly. Marginalized communities, marginalized individuals find themselves often on the heavy hand of surveillance. And usually if you go to places where these people aggregate, live, collect, there's many layers of surveillance. And I just try to make sure people understand circumvention technologies to get around the surveillance, but also what these machines are, who put them there, all that good stuff. And for that, it means learning about how to use GPG, which is a great technology that you don't rely on a third party for. It's all there with you. And having those key signing parties and making them part of the conversation, because all too often, they're not only highly targeted, but also marginalized outside of a lot of this great information.
Now, I know a lot of people inside the security community, technologists, who listen to these kind of stories and are motivated and want to help, but they can't quit their day job. For whatever reason, they're going to have to work for corporations, for companies, traditional sort of what we do. Is there room for people to do this part-time in their spare time? Do you have to be all or nothing, or can you be a little bit in?
Well, when I started Crypto Harlem, which is this work focused on the inner city, I had a full-time job, and it was like more than full-time. It was quite a lot of hours. Being a public interest technologist is a state of mind. You can do it anywhere. You can volunteer at a school or work with children or go to your public library that always has an open area for people to speak about issues. And that's what I started doing. There was people who were working in New York City doing crypto parties out of Brooklyn Public Library. I attended those and tried to assist before I had time to start my own thing, which is a community center very close to where I live. So when I got off of work, I just walk a few blocks to do it. And I think it's just about being creative and imaginative. We don't realize, as people who live this and breathe this, how a lot of the information just is not accessible to most people. And it's also not welcoming. And you are a human. You can make eye contact. You can answer a question. And it goes a long way. And I just kind of spark that in people. And then they end up reading, like, you know, Schneier blog or all other great content, Bruce. Like, you know, so I think, like, now I have people who are like, hey, did you get the new book on this or that or something, you know? And in originally, I would be the one pointing them to a lot of these sources, tech journalism, et cetera. So I think anyone can do this with any time. Also, a lot of companies will give you time to volunteer. Out of the year, they'll say, you know, you could do a 5K walk or a 10K run or whatever. And you can also just say, hey, can I actually just volunteer and go to the school or community center? And then they'll say yes, and you'll get that 8 hours or 4 hours to make that happen. So sometimes it's just about asking and finding out. You'd be surprised.
Sort of nice to hear. And I mean, I think one of the problems we're going to have is how do we scale all this? Mm-hmm. So last question, where do you think this is all going? I mean, what are the issues of tomorrow that we kind of want to start thinking about today? Getting people to understand, getting people motivated. What do we have to teach now for the future?
Well, I think that everyone opens up a paper today and the word like hacking is in there or privacy was in there. And it's about getting people to understand what's at stake and the role that they play. You know, it's not bigger than all of us. In fact, it's right in front of us in our phones, on our social media. You know, we have a vested interest, and there's a lot of people who say, well, it's all out there, it's too late. And I challenge that and say, you know, it's never too late for you to have that positive impact. So the issues that really excite me are things having to do with our democracy that holds the country together, our governance and policies, and how we treat each other as individuals, and also how we treat formerly incarcerated people, marginalized communities, et cetera, that really helps us understand like where we are. What are we doing to those at most risk with our technology? And are we bringing positive things from the beautiful thing about technology? Because I know I'm a fan of tech, and I know you're a fan of tech. Or and are we looking out for the most harmful things and those who are most at risk? And I think that's what I'm focused on, and those are things that really interest me and things like that.
Well, thank you.
Thank you. This has been awesome. It's great to talk to you.
All right. Let's figure out how to make lots more of you.
Yeah, exactly. Start the cloning machine.
All right.
Okay.